Hi viewers, welcome to Penhouse Taunton. In this video, we are going to see a short review on AirMail Valet 69T and eyedropper model fountain pen. This video is specifically taken to give you the clear insights on the pen because just with photos, you cannot fully understand the pen. So here, T means transparent body, the cap held on the body with thread mechanism, and these both cap and the grips are resembling the same green color marble finished one. And this is a silver trim portion where there is a silver clip and a silver ring on the cap. And here there is a breather hole. This will prevents ink from clogging and maintains a balanced atmospheric pressure so that the ink does not leak or drip ink through the nibs. And the brand's name Valetty also engraved in this clip portion, and it is also stamped in the body portion. And here, this is number 8 nib with a fine tipped gold plated one, and you can swap the nibs as you like since we have number 8 nibs in many brand, and also number 35 nib suits this pen. In 35 we are having an broad and flex too. Usually pen enthusiasts will swap with can write nibs where we have a fine medium broad flex and again with gold dual tone and with silver tipped also. And here the choice is yours. And for that, you can go to our size and site and click pen spares. Then you can use a you can select pen spares. Then you can go to nibs and there you can use a filter and you can make a query on what you require. Now to the measurements. The holding area's diameter is 10.2 mm and the body is 13.5 mm and the length of the pen without cap is 133.7 mm, and the length of this pen with cap is 148.5 mm. And here these measurements will give some ideas about the pouches and holders for this pen. And now to the entire weight of this pen is 23 grams. And here, since the holding area diameter is a bigger one, this pen is more suitable for big fingers who have for adults. And also the reservoir capacity is more, you can fill more than 3 ml of inks in this. And also please note, since this is a transparent body, please do not use primary color ink so that it will create a strain on the body of the wall of this pen. And on pen maintenance, please wash the pens regularly, that is twice a month, because all the dye based ink like our Penhouse ink or Brill, Sulika or Dayton and all, those dye based ink will precipitate on the longer usage, so it will block the ink's passage in the feeder, so you will get a scratchy writing and slowly the ink dries quickly, and then you may have to shake the pens for the ink flow to come out. So I think you may experience this, and the reason is the blockage in the feeder screw. So to clean the deposits and dirts, please remove the feeder and the nib unit separately by holding this together and twist and pull this out, so you will get it easily removed easily. And then you can flush the feeder with the help of a toothbrush or any brush and clean it well with soap water. If you are soaking in soap water, then allow it for an hour and brush and clean. And in some ink bottles itself, you can notice on every fill it is recommended to clean the pen with water. So here I'm going to show that. This is Brill ink bottle, so here it is given. Clean your pen with water before filling with Brill ink. It is unique formulation, prevents clogging and aids quick drying on paper. So it is clear. Unless otherwise we have good cleaning and maintenance, the flow will be affected. And here, all the threads are turned to on out. So to increase the life of the thread, please apply a silicone grease or Vaseline whenever you are opening and closing the grip section for the ink fill. This will give you a long life for the thread portions. And whenever you fill the ink, fill below the inner threads. If you fill in excess, you will get a leakage path and your hands may get spoiled. And also, few nibs need to be fine-tuned. because during the manual assembly of nib, the tines may stick together. So gently push the tines like this up and down. So it will create some space in between the tines and you will get a good ink flow and smooth writing in turn. And whenever you fill the ink, whenever you doing this, please make sure both the tines are parallel. If not, you will get a scratchy writing. And we will check before dispatch to our customers. Whenever we dispatch the pens, we will check all the details and we will do fine tuning and all. And this is our usual practice. And now I'm going to give the writing sample of this pen. For today's writing, I'm going to use our Penhouse violet color ink. Yeah, this is writing so smooth and fine. Yeah, comparing to before, Violet T pens nibs are writing so well. Yeah, the writing is so awesome and so smooth, and the ink flow is coming out so uniformly. And yeah, if you have any query about this pen, you can ask in the comment section or else you can make a call to our mobile number. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.